Hiya fellas, I am the one, and today I wanna do a follow-up on my last video entitled, The Fantasy Trap. After I did that video, I realized why the hell women love the 50 Shades of Grey book. Many MGTOW producers have covered time and time again why women love the Titanic movie. And that's because of male disposability, the idea that a man would be willing to sacrifice his life to save a woman's life. That's why that movie became the number one movie in the world for several years. In that same spirit, I'm gonna cover the 50 Shades book. According to Wikipedia, quote, 50 Shades of Grey has topped bestseller lists around the world, including those of the United Kingdom and the United States. The series had sold over 125 million copies worldwide by June 2015 and has been translated into 52 languages, and set a record in the United Kingdom as the fastest-selling paperback of all time, unquote. A woman gets wet at the thought of a Christian Grey showing up in their boring lives, degrading them sexually and treating them like objects, but they don't like thinking of themselves as objects. All of that is obvious, but what is under the hood is the idea of a rich, young, handsome, and perverted man putting himself in the position to be completely destroyed by a regular Jane. But you might say, hey the one, but don't they sign consent forms? Yeah right, more on that later. On my previous video I talked about how some women have the rape fantasy. But if you are the one with the balls or the stupidity to give in to her desires and agree to fulfill that fantasy, you have just put your head on the guillotine and she holds the rope. All she has to do is let go of that rope. You just gave her 100% control over what happens to your life from now on. She might use that power or she might not, but simply having the power to do it is enough to get her drunk on power. She knows that all she has to do to destroy you is to say you beat her, or that you raped her, that's all. She doesn't even need the evidence to support it, but if she has the evidence on her body in the shape of bruises, lacerations, or any other form, game over, she won, she has you by the balls. Once she has you, she can do all kinds of things. She can get you to do things you don't want to do by blackmailing you, or simply turning you in for abuse and you're done. One person who comes to mind was Gian Gamaishi from a Canadian radio station. He had fame and fortune, and also engaged in BDSM sex. For more information about what happened to him, check the link in the description. Long story short, one of his ex-girlfriends decided to accuse him of domestic violence and non-consensual rough sex, even though they had signed consent forms, but at the end of the day, those consent forms aren't worth shit just like prenups, and he was fucked in court. He got arrested and charged with 4 counts of assault and 1 count of choking a bitch. In the end he spent a fortune on lawyers, he got acquitted of all 5 charges, but he still lost it all and he's no longer on the radio. I think that's the appeal of 50 Shades, a rich guy's willingness to put his neck in the guillotine and give her control and power to destroy him. So you see, the ultimate aphrodisiac for women is not to be degraded and treated like shit, but in reality, it's power, the power to destroy a man's life with a single word. Power is the ultimate high. I think that's why a woman will come like a broken dam like never before when being degraded. It's the power she's getting over you when you're degrading her. In my case, my ex-wife tried to get me to put my head on the guillotine, but I didn't do it. Unfortunately, I had already given her enough ammunition to destroy me socially in my circle of friends. She talked shit, mostly lies, and some truths here and there, but mostly lies. At the end of the day, she had turned me into the bad guy and lost friends, very good friends, or so I thought. Anyway, that's a different story for another day. I hope you don't put yourself in that situation in which you can be destroyed. It's not worth the risk. 11 seconds of climax doesn't compare to the shitstorm that awaits you if she opens her mouth. You're MGTOW, now you know better. No woman is worth going to jail for DV, none. Remember, your life is valuable, you are valuable. You are not a disposable commodity. Just go your own way. Till next time, have a good day.